What is up, guys, and welcome to a very special video, which is gonna be my first analytical, kind of a little bit less fan reaction, more fan thought talk thingamajig about the Wild, and mostly about the NHL. Something I kind of want to do is to kind of expand towards more NHL related topics rather than just me acting weird around the Minnesota Wild. However, this first issue is probably gonna have a little bit of a wild twist on it because I want to still expand in a manner where I still feel safe talking about it and still feel like I have an opinion about it all. Well, more so, I have a bit of understanding of the subject since I am a fan and I kind of see the rumors as they go along. In this video, I'm gonna talk about probably the most talked about player in the NHL since training camp started, which is gonna be William Nylander. And I kind of wanted to touch on this now because you're starting to see like the time run up a little bit, and it's like, okay, this might actually be a thing where Toronto may have to trade a really, really good prospect to another team because he doesn't want to sign, which is something I haven't really seen that much before. I still think he's going to sign with the Leafs if you're gonna ask me like right now what I think, but I'm starting to go over to the point where he may move to another team, and that will be a bit of a blow, I think, to Carl Dubas, especially for the Leafs side, because he had the front three monster of Marner, Matthews, Nylander, and then he added on Tavares. You just see that four-headed beast. You just think that is just gonna be a scary thing to face for anyone. However, it looks like it may get one of its head cut off. And from a Leafs perspective, I think that's horrible for them. I think it's horrible for the new GM, Carl Dubas, which I still think is a good GM. Don't get me wrong. I'm not going to be like, oh, they should have kept Lou Lamoriello. They should have hired Mike Hunter. No, I think they did the right thing by hiring Carl Dubas. However, I think it is a little bit of a blow to his probably backroom and a little bit towards what he had kind of envisioned towards the team. But let's go into why we watched a Wild fan talk about it. What does this have of implications for the Wild? Probably not that many implications, to be honest, but it's fun to speculate. And you go on Twitter, you kind of search Nylander on Wild, you see a few ru not rumors but speculations, because it isn't rumors, it isn't something that like, oh, we saw him with this guy. No, it is just like, this could be a thing that might happen. And I think the biggest rumor was that Carl Dubas was in Minnesota watching a game once, and you go, oh, he must be trying to trade with us. Well, or that, or he just want to scout opponents. That, or he just likes hockey, something like that. To get back on the point, what would the Wild have to trade to get William Nylander? And to that, we kind of look back to Carl Dubas, who has released a statement, I think, to all teams to shortlist untouchables and players they would want to trade for Nylander. And to kind of go into Paul Finson's mind a little bit and try and speculate in his mind, who do I think the untouchables are? The first one I think is easy because I cannot see us trade Kaprizov, especially considering Fenton went to meet him earlier this week. He went to Russia, he went to see him play, he went to have dinner with the family, he went to send a letter. There's no way he's going, right? The second player I cannot see us trade right now because he is just doing fantastically. Unless the Leafs gave us the moon for him, that would be Mikael Granlund. I think he's staying, and I think he's going to stay a long time. And then I have a third one, which is probably the most controversial of my untouchables, at least. Matt Dumba. So I've seen this trade proposed by a lot of people that the Wild should trade Matt Dumba for Nylander, straight up. And to that, I say no. Because why would we trade probably one of our best defensive prospects we have in the system? If you look at it, we have Dumba, who had 50 points last season, who has been great defensively, who's been great physically, who's just taken that extra step this season. Why would we want to trade him for William Nylander? The fun thing is, had you asked me before the season started, I might have agreed to that trade straight up. However, watching Dumba, watching how important he is to our defense, watching how important he is to a power play, I don't want to do that trade. I think Dumba is doing fantastic as he is. And don't get me wrong, Nylander is a great player. He is a fantastic player who would definitely improve the Wild team. He would give us some youth prospect up front, which would be amazing. However, you look at that trade and think, is this gonna be a Charlie Coyle for Brett Burns situation once again? I think Nylander is better than Charlie Coyle, and I think he would definitely go into our top six, probably our top one line. However, you start looking at that trade and think Dumba might turn into exactly what Brett Burt was, and what he is going to be is potentially that. And I don't want to trade another Norris winner potentially. So the next trade I saw did include Dumba as well. However, it was more so even, I think, because the Leafs traded Jake Gardner and William Nylander for Matt Dumba and Ino Niederreiter. And that trade is, again, interesting. I still think the fact that we sell pretty much two players who is established, and I think Dumba especially is better than Jake Gardner at the moment defensively. He has more of a body to him. He throws the body a little bit more. He is a bit more physical than Jake Gardner. But Jake Gardner is a great player as well. He is just that offensive powerhouse. We'd have replaced Matt Dumba as well. So I understand why people suggested this trade. It makes sense that we maybe give up the better defenseman but get something back. But we give up the worst forward to get a better forward. I can see the trade makes sense. However, you have to relax on that as well, in my opinion. Because Nylander is better than Niederreiter. However, Niederreiter is kind of on a slump so far. He's been a little bit snake-bitten. And you have to not overreact when a player is snake-bitten, when he doesn't get the goals, because then you make bad trades. You saw it potentially with the Penguins and LA, which is a desperate trade of Tanner Pearson, who has started slow, and then you just trade him for Hägglund, which is a player who started a little bit better, but is older. You have to watch out with trades where you go into desperation due to a slump. And then there's the last element I want to talk about William Nylander, especially going to the Wild, but also to other teams. You cannot just trade him, right? You have to sign him. And how much does he want for your team? And how much are you willing to pay? He would sign with the team. And how much would he ask? Probably more than 6.6 that I think the Leafs have been asking for a while. He would have to sign for at least 7, right? 7 to 8? I know his asking price from his agents is 8 million. That is too much for William Nylander in my eyes. That's a bad contract in my eyes. Again, William Nylander is a great player. That is too much, in my opinion. But it is a trade that is worth looking at, in my opinion, for a lot of teams. Especially if you can get Nylander's agents to kind of back down to maybe 7. Maybe 7, around 7, 6.8. I think he's worth that. I do not think he's worth Draisaitl money. I don't think he necessarily is worth that much. However, if you can get him down to that range, I will say look into that trade. But I don't think he wants that. I think he wants more. And I hate to say, I think his agent is kind of too much in his ear for his own good. I think he should just sign the contract with the Leaf. Kind of sign a bridge deal. Potentially sign something that's more like Pasternak's money. Because I think that's what Nylander is. I think he's a Pasternak Elos type player. But not that Marner Matthews player. But yeah, this is probably what I had to say about the Nylander trade and kind of how I think it could work for the Wild. I don't want to see a straight Dumba. I think that's what the league want us to do. I don't think we are going to do it. I think Fenton is kind of like, we have to keep Dumba because he is that great defender that I think we have to build our future around defensively. Kind of to round up, where do I think he will end up? Probably with the Leaf. If he is going to end up in the team, I think he's going to end up in Carolina, but time will tell, and once we know more, I'll probably make like a small video kind of to follow up on this one. Anyways, that is it for this video. Hope you like this new concept that I kind of want to try and work out a little bit more hockey analytical rather than just Wild analytical, despite this being a lot about the Wild, of course. But hope you enjoyed it. Please click like if you did. Show me like what I can do better in the comments. Subscribe if you will. Really enjoyed it, and have a good day.